We're at the Apollo Theater in Harlem, USA.
Willie, Miss Melodie, McBoo. You know what? We also have Derek in the house.
This is KRS-One.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Good.
All right.
So maybe we should first explain what KRS-One stands for.
Well, basically, KRS is my name, Chris, right. Except I spell it K-R-I-S. And in throughout my course of rhyming and so on, I've dropped the I and just labeled it KRS. Down the line, a couple of other KRSs started to come out. So I started to label myself KRS-One. I gave each one of the letters a meaning, which the entire name would mean knowledge reigns supreme over nearly everyone. I left home at 13, and it was basically a very childish move, but it was a real one, yeah. Very real. And I left home to live on the streets of Harlem, Brooklyn, Bronx, Queens, Staten Island, everywhere. I've been everywhere in New York. I used to sleep in most of the parks that the kids were going, like I'd wake up and I'd see them coming in off the train, off the school bus or whatever, and I'd just pick up, dust myself off, and go to school. I was studying to be a cartoonist, which was my other profession. And there I took up psychology as a minor, philosophy as a major, and media art as a major. Music came along because I was studying poetry. When I was living on the street, I used to love poetry. I still do. But then that's all I had to do every day, mm-hmm. was write poems and eat. That's it. BDP was basically designed for a twofold purpose. One was to grasp that street image, the street life we lived, and to put it in a mainstream sense, because the ghetto has no one to speak for them.
Black on black violence. I mean, how do you feel about that right now? What's happening to it?
No other rap artists would speak against nonviolence because it wasn't cool. It wasn't the fad at the time. So here comes BDP again. We come out with a record, Stop the Violence. Now, being this is on my second album, we had already gained the respect of the ghetto-orientated kids. Right. Like, Criminal Minded is it, and that was it. So they're listening now. Say what? Stop the violence! In the house! In the house! Violence really is a way of life. It is the intelligent people who curb it, who rise up above it, and say, we're going to try and stop it. And if you want to go to the tip top, stop the violence in hip-hop, Y-I-O. Peace doesn't come with a flower. Peace. If you really want world peace, you have to take it.
Gotta put our heads together and stop the violence, because real bad boys move in silence.
Kids follow fads more than they do laws. Yeah. Kids follow fads more than they do their parents.
So you're a philosopher?
Yes. Yes.
What had happened was me and Scott got into like a little debate, whereas I was saying that I think I have something different to say than these other guys. Mm-hmm. And Scott was saying, well, if you think you're better, then you should do something about it. So I was saying, well, I don't think I'm better. I just think I have something better to say.
On the mic, I believe that you should get loose. I haven't come to tell you I got juice. I just produce, create, innovate on a higher level. I'll be back,
but for now, just settle.
So here comes BDP with clear and concise messages. We're here to how would I say, knock out the stereotypes. Knock them out completely.